Have you ever wondered where the term avant-garde comes from? Or what the hell it actually is?
The term comes from French and literally means advanced guard or vanguard.
Today, it refers to people or works that are experimental or innovative, particularly in respect to arts, culture, and politics. Once upon a time, the phrase came from a very telling place. It was used in the military. It was used in English during the 15th to 18th centuries. The avant-garde générale, the avant-garde stratégique, avant-garde d'armée. Anyway, they were all a strong force of one, two, or three army corps that were pushed out to the very front in a day's march, immediately behind the cavalry screen.
The avant-garde were the expendables, the ones on the fringes.
Their purpose was to vigorously engage the enemy first, and by binding him, ensure liberty of action for the main army. The term was borrowed again in 1910 as the artistic term we now use today for pioneers or innovators of a particular period. Avant-garde represents a pushing of the boundaries of what is acceptable, accepted as the norm or the status quo, primarily in the cultural realm. The notion of the existence of the avant-garde is considered by some to be a hallmark of modernism, as distinct from postmodernism. Many artists have aligned themselves with the avant-garde movement, and still continue to do so. But the avant-garde is a big term, and we must focus. And today we must focus on
the theater.
Hey guys. So, can you believe I just did that? I know. So, experimental theater is a general term used for various movements in Western theater that began in the late 19th century with Alfred Jarry and his Ubu plays. It began as a form of anti-tradition, a rejection of both the era itself and, in general, the dominant ways and means of producing plays. The term has shifted over time as the mainstream theater world has adopted many of the ways in theater that were once considered radical. It's more or less used completely interchangeably with the term avant-garde theater. Experimental theater is exactly what it sounds like. It's the theater of trying something new! So, like other forms of the avant-garde, it was created as a result of a perceived general cultural crisis. Despite different political and formal approaches, all avant-garde theater opposes mainstream theater, or bourgeois theater. And for those of you who don't know anything unless it's in a musical, you can find the term bourgeois and bourgeoisie in such musicals as Fiddler on the Roof, Evita, and Once on This Island. It experiments with different uses of language and the physicalizations of the body to change the mode of perception and to create a new, more active engagement with its audience. So, experimental theater is very basically defined by a few markers. Now, these are just guideposts, but here they are anyway. One, relationships to an audience. Famed experimental theater director and playwright Peter Brook describes his task as building a necessary theater, one in which there is only a practical difference between actor and audience,
not a fundamental one.
Traditional audiences are seen as passive observers. You've been that guy. Hell, I've been that guy. Who hasn't been that guy? Who hasn't been to see their cousin play Max Detweiler in an all-female production of The Sound of Music and wanted to die? Look, all I'm saying is that experimental theater practitioners wanted to challenge that.
For example, one of Bertolt Brecht's crucial principles was Verfremdungseffekt, translated as defamiliarization or estrangement effect, and often mistranslated as the alienation effect. He wanted to mobilize his audiences by asking them questions and not giving them answers, thereby getting them to think for themselves. Augusto Boal created the Theater of the Oppressed, and he wanted his audiences to react directly to the action.
While hunky, hunky Antonin Artaud wanted to affect the audience directly on a subconscious level with his theater of cruelty.
Peter Brook identified a triangle of relationships within a performance. First, the performer's internal relationships. Next, the performer's relationships to each other on stage. And finally, their relationship with the audience. It's sort of like a circle, with the audience providing one half of the energy for the evening and the performers providing the other.
Two. The second marker is social contexts. Some groups have been prominent in changing the social face of theater rather than its stylistic appearance. Theater makers have used their skills to engage in a form of cultural activism which can take many different forms.
For example, going back to Augusto Boal, he used the legislative theater in Rio to find out what the people wanted to change about their community. He used the audience's reaction to change legislation in his role as counselor.
Basically, experimental theater encourages theater makers to take society in the form of an audience and change their attitudes, values, and beliefs. And not only to do that, but to get them to do something about it. Three, methods of creation. So, traditionally, there is a highly hierarchical method of creating theater. A writer writes a script, a director interprets that script, the performers perform, and when they perform it, they perform the director and writer's collective vision. Experimental theater practitioners started challenging this and started treating and viewing the performers as creative artists in their own right. This started with giving them more and more interpretive freedom, and then eventually developed into what we now call devised theater.
Performers have also started challenging their individual roles. An interdisciplinary approach becomes more and more common as performers have become less willing to be pigeonholed. And other disciplines have started breaking down their barriers. Dance, music, visual art, and writing become blurred in many cases. And artists with completely separate trainings and backgrounds now collaborate very comfortably.
Four, physical effects. This one's fairly straightforward. Experimental theater alters traditional conventions of space, movement, mood, tension, language, symbolism, and countless other elements. Homework. It's pretty simple. I want you to research four experimental or avant-garde theater practitioners, schools of thought, or directors, and briefly describe them and send them in an email to me. That's your homework for part two. Have fun, and keep experimenting.
La pendule fait tic-tac, tic-tic. Les oiseaux du lac pic-pac, pic-pic. Glou-glou-glou font tous les dindons. Et la jolie cloche ding-ding-dong. Mais boum! Quand notre cœur fait boum, tout avec lui dit boum, et c'est l'amour qui s'éveille. Boum, il chante Loving Bloom, au rythme de ce boum qui redit boum à l'oreille. Tout a changé depuis hier et la rue a des yeux qui regardent aux fenêtres. Y a du lilas et y a des mains tendues sur la mer, le soleil va paraître. Boum, l'astre du jour fait